I still had that thing for free coffee in here from Easter. So we can get done.
Steph said to me, remember all that paperwork we had to do at the end of the night? And I went, yeah.
Why are you getting stuff?
I get a lot of this crap for Jennifer.
Mm. Okay.
I don't know why. I delete it. And here's another one. Hey, Jennifer, I am Tyler, one of the waiters who served you 2 weeks ago. You had left this at our restaurant.
Let's see what they left.
No. What restaurant?
It gives you the website.
In other words, it's garbage.
That's what I think, so that's why I delete them. Because they don't even... They don't even have the right phone numbers. Dorinda was mad we didn't clean up the mess. Kathy knows we didn't clean up, and then the next day it's, hope Kathy not mad at me, Dorinda was mad we didn't clean up the mess.
Well, it's out of the usual stuff, so some heroes wear capes, some heroes make your coffee. A Titan frozen mocha, sugar free with no whipped cream.
Extra shot.
Unfortunately, I am actually out of my sugar free mocha for the present.
Still.
What do they have for frozen drinks?
Do you have some other frozen drinks that are sugar free?
Sure, white chocolate.
Sugar-free white chocolate, I guess.
With extra shot.
Alright, anything else?
No.
Okay,
yep.
Alright,
thank you.
Mm-hmm.
And they let it dry, but they didn't clean it up.
They just charge of the shift, and she said, I would assume Gala.
It's their problem.
She was the one who called Kathy.
Your mouth, it's your brain.
No, it's the fact that the brain didn't work until after the words are already out of the mouth. That would be a lot of us. Remember how Lynn got after he got smacked in the head?
Yeah, but that was different.
That was so unlike Lynn.
Yeah.
Once you start doing that, you can't shut it off. It just comes up more and more.
nasty.
What?
That is nasty.
Jen always says it tastes like a sheep.
That is terrible. That is utterly terrible.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Oh, that's so nasty.
You might want to keep your mouth shut till we get clear.
Yeah. No, that is nasty. I can't drink that. That's
then don't
terrible.
Drink it, okay?
That is
then don't bitch
that
about
is
it
nasty.
Either. You don't like it, that's fine. I just spent something else that you didn't like.
Well, sir, you're the one that talked into it, dude, getting it. I didn't
Sorry.
Really want it.
Don't go too far
that
down this road.
That was my fault.
Don't go too far down the road here.
We can go home and
we can do all kinds of things.
We can add
we have
some
lots
chocolate
of things
to it.
We have to do, so.
Yeah.
Desperately needs food.
Yes, I get that. I totally get that.
And we got to get down and get the garbage out of the site because nobody else is going to do it.
We're going to go get the garbage out of the site.
Yeah, because nobody else is going to go down there and take it out.
But they did. And I told
them. They'll fill it up. They won't take it out.
I told them that if I had a means to get it out of there, I would have, but I didn't. And nobody else has touched it. They told me to go get it. All right.
Because you're in the field this year.
Right.
Who knows?
Garbage can full.
Hope it's in a garbage bag.
No.
What?
Just telling you the way it was. I didn't set it up. All I did was Dean and I made sure the big stuff that was overflowing left. We didn't have anything to put it in. So it was still in the can. So other people have been down here and they haven't touched it. So guess what?
shot, and she doesn't have sugar free, so.
It almost tastes like, not white chocolate. It kind of almost tastes like
malt or something.
No,
it's hard to describe.
I can't remember the fruit that we used to get.
Bananas?
No.
Apricots?
No. It's not a watermelon, but a
cantaloupe. Kind of,
yeah, it has a cantaloupe taste to it.
Does it really?
Yeah.
That's different.
Mm-hmm.
That is different.
Well, once you get the water out of it and you start sucking the ice, it has a cantaloupe taste to it.
Mm.
But when it's the water, yeah, but when you get down to the actual sucking the ice, it has that cantaloupe taste, kind of a little, kind of like a half taste of it.
It's way different.
Yeah, no. Well, really, I don't mind cantaloupe, but I don't. This taste is a little more. I'll suck it down because you bought it, but.
Thank you. We'll figure out not to do that.
We haven't had the sugar-free chocolate.
Sunday's noon to 6. Okay. That's right. Well, I wanted to take a look, you see, because I got a bunch of things I got to try. I have a lot of things I have to try to do.
Yeah, I get it.
I like Sarah preaching. She reminds me of Sister Simmons in a way. Sister Simmons used to preach. She was good too. Then when I got dreams, they're called flashbacks.
kind of Sunday school.
Yeah. But it was going to be just me and Mabel. And two other people that normally come in, came in. Which is funny though, because we saw some people in church that sometimes come to our group that just didn't come to Sunday.
Might not have had time today. They might have.
Could have been. And I understand it's summer and things are going on.
It's going away quick.
Mm-hmm.
Because I'm not going to have big garbage bags, but I don't want one.
Okay. Be nice if we got down there and Joe already did it. Well, they said he was going out there yesterday. Well, so. I don't know.
I don't have a problem with doing it. It's just that they had to have, they had garbage bags out there that I could see. Dean and I would have taken it away that day.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you think they would have.
They may, but where are they at?
Yeah, well, you know,
are they next
to the
garbage
That's a lot of
cans?
Things there.
Yeah. Into it was entertaining, but
for sure.
Well, it's bigger tires than are on the Durango.
No, these are bigger. These are 20 inches.
That's what I'm saying. They're bigger tires than are on the Durango.
Plus, it's just as a truck, it's a little higher.
Well, now you've got pretty much a full tank. Let's go get kitty food.
Luckily, one bag seems to last quite a while.
Well, it's only one cat.
Yeah, well, that's true.
That's the help.
One bag at least seems like it lasts about a month. Close to a month.
Hemis, though, they do suck some oil too.
Yeah.
Both of them.
Oh, I saw the they have a new model out for the 2020 Fords. For the F1 or it's the F-150 or all the models or something.
They're all aluminum body.
No, see, they're coming out with a new version for Ford, which is almost exclusive to the Raptors only.
Nope.
They have an off-road type of mode that's supposed to compete directly with the Power Wagon.
Really?
Well, Power Wagon has a 6.4 liter gas Hemi engine.
It's a big engine.
Well, Ford is this tritium package or whatever they're calling it. It's supposed to be available on all models or something of it, but you get two different engine packages. 6.6 liter Power Stroke diesel with supposedly puts out like, they say, 1,000 foot-pounds or 1,000 horsepower or something like that.
Ridiculous amount.
A 1,000 foot-pounds or whatever it is.
That would be torque.
But torque, or I can't remember if it was 1,000 horsepower equivalent, but it was more for the diesel than it was for the gas.
Well, yeah.
And the gas was a 7.3 liter, 595 horsepower. I'm like, good God.
Well, for the really down.
Imagine if you fitted that sucker to an F-150.
No, it's too much horses. Or,
I don't know, but my goodness.
It'd be fast.
Man, that's a big engine.
It would be fast. There'd be no hesitation.
Oh, yeah. And I guess they said it has a lot more pulling power. I guess the Power Wagon does not have very much pulling power.
Really?
It's not really meant for pulling.
Really?
Huge loads, apparently. They said it's got a 10,000 pound tow load or something, which I guess this new version of their engines or something, and the way their new engine package thing is, it's rated to almost 15,000 pounds.
Holy
smokes. I could be wrong, but I think that's what the guys said on it.
Okay.
It's a lot. I could be wrong on the specs, but I believe that's what I heard on the Fastlane Trucks YouTube channel. That's what they were talking about. So look it up. I could be totally wrong. But it was something like in that figure number. It was way more better than the Power Wagon. Even unless we were looking at 2019 Power Wagon versus the 2020 Ford. Now what? 2020, I don't know. We'll see. If it inspires competition, though.
It was a
V8. Yeah.
I don't remember what size it was. Whether it was a 318 or a 3... whatever.
Uh-huh.
But it had lots of horses, but we managed to bury it right up to the door we were doing.
Well, this is an 8-speed.
This was back then.
Yeah.
We burned up transmissions in them all the time because of the cold.
Yep. Got 345 horsepower,
yep.
375 torque, 375 pounds of torque. Rick's has a 395 horsepower, only 410 of foot pounds of torque.
Okay, let's break on.
So it's got it doesn't have as high of a ratio for the torque compared to mine.
Because it's got 8-speed transmission.
Yeah.
This is only a 5 or something like that.
No, I think this is an 8.
No.
What's that?
Do not think so. I think it's
maybe it's wrong. I could be wrong. I don't know.
I think.
I can't remember it.
Eights are fairly new. Jen's got an 8 in her car. That's why it does good with miles.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know if this is... I thought it was an 8-speed.
I don't think so.
I don't know. Whatever 2008 was. Five.
So we're still back in the 5-speed. Wonder what this
whatever
truck is doing here.
Hook up to that trailer.
Fifth wheeler, yeah.
Yellowstone. I said, well, you could drop by and feed her and do your stuff. She says, I didn't run it down.
I said, fine. What?
She didn't have a problem with it.
Okay, good. practically the 1500 is a better choice. It's heavier than a half.
Yeah.
It's like a heavy duty half ton, which for most things is all you need.
Well, you got more power than an F-150 normally. Normally F-150 has.
Other than the rust, it's a
well,
good
actually,
truck.
For this, long, you know,
for as
11
old as
years
it is,
old,
beat up as it is, it's pretty
and
good.
And this kind of mileage, it's actually really good. And I believe the majority of it was because that guy who was the purse manager at Chrysler had him
fix it up all the time.
Well, yeah, and only started to rust when he probably sold it to the other guy who didn't keep it very long.
Right. Well, I'll break off a piece of the paint. I'll go in and talk to him, tell him what color I think it is. He can tell me what color it really is. I mean, mix up some paint, peel off the
actually,
chunks.
If you go to one of these places, they can...
I know where to go.
Yeah.
I've been doing it for years.
Okay? They can, like, digital read it and they can make it, like, right there.
Yes, that's... Where do you think I've been getting paint at for all these years?
I watched the thing on Top Gear where they took in... they were trying to make an old people's car. So they took in a hearing aid, and they said they wanted the exact color of the hearing aid, that like tannish, kind of like this color.
Yep.
And they said, can you make it like this? Yep. Guy says, we can make any color of anything. He says, so he jokes, says, can you make a color paint the color of my left nipple? Like, he says, sure.
Scan it first.
Sure we can. Yes, we can. So if you really want that, we can do that. Okay.
Take a couple of these big garbage bags in there, and we'll dump everything into one of them and leave a couple big ones there. I think the club should probably buy a porta potty. It's probably, if you're going to spend $100 a weekend to rent one, you can buy a used one for $150.
Yeah, I don't know.
Use it 3 times a year.
Yeah, and they can come up, clean it, and service it. So.
Yeah, they would. You pay $50 or $100 to service
it. Yeah.
Be on site.
Yeah.
You wouldn't have to go wonder.
Yeah. Make sure it was sealed up. Pretty good.
Yeah.
Don't need $1 million to get in there.
Yeah, that would make it
that
more
entertaining. That would be kind of not so good.
That would make it more entertaining for sure.
Go to sit down and have a spider crawl up here.
An attention getter.
Yeah. Or even worse, have a tick crawl up.
Well, there's plenty of ticks out there.
I'm not in for the ticks. So I didn't walk on in the grass when I was out there. So it's like, I don't need anything coming home. So enough of those little bugs come out.
I pulled a bunch of them off me when I was out there.
You were walking in the grass or anything else.
Yes, I was.
But walking the grass.
Yeah, well, I had to. Because what I was working on was in the grass. So.
Somebody should have mowed before they went out there. But
well,
that would have kept them down.
Feel free to jump out there and get on it.
No, not really.
Yeah.
Flamethrower.
Part of the problem.
Flamethrower. No more ticks. No more bugs. No more problems. We're dumping a whole bunch of chemicals out there. Bleach ought to do it real good. Do some battery acid that should kill everything. Just don't mix the two.
Once you fold them up, they're kind of like a dent trailer.
Yeah.
And then when they're up there.
But they're hard sided though.
They're harder.
Now I don't know if they're hard enough sides for bear country.
I don't know.
One lady on there said some of these newer ones, the hard sides are good enough for bear, for if you're like staying in like a place that's prone to bears and stuff like Yellowstone and stuff.
Really?
And I'm like, yeah, well, not the first thought I would be wanting to do, but. Better than a soft-sided one for sure.
And they don't let them do it.
Well, they won't. Yeah.
One of our girls from high school went up to Yellowstone. Was sleeping in a sleeping bag.
God.
Grizzly went in after her and made a mess out of her.
Mm-hmm. They were showing a thing on. It was up in Alaska. This guy was kind of in the winter, or in close to winter. This guy had a fire. He didn't have a tent, just had a sleeping bag and stuff, and had like a lean-to with a little canvas thing to reflect the heat in. He got an interesting surprise, and he woke up. Bear sleeping right next to, pretty much almost right next to him. Next to the fire.
Perfect.
Big grizzly.
And quietly get out of the
just
way.
Came in, you know, probably the only warmth in the area. But his friend came up to the area and took a picture and was like, oh! So you have this big, huge grizzly. Big grizzly. Kind of curled up like a cat, sleeping. And then this guy is sleeping in a sleeping bag. It's like his feet are only like maybe a foot away from the bear's back. Like
snake in a sleeping bag was the story I read.
Let's get up and get the hell out of there.
One of the ladies at work is related to this guy. This is her uncle.
Yeah.
So he's got a well out there somewhere. So he'd be looking for water to get some kind of treatment these days.
How good the well might be, and who knows?
Well, politely ask if he wants some water. Otherwise, you got to truck it out here. Which is a mini pickup truck, so we're in the room. Shouldn't be that hard.
Do you want to back in then?
Nope. Inside with me. The 39-gallon garbage can full of crap.
Yeah.
It's after Dean and I drug other stuff out. So.
Yeah.
This is weird at night when you're backing up, because when you think you're on the road, you're not.
Yeah, I know.
Especially right in this area here, I was like, what did I do? And I couldn't tell
at night.
Go around this other thing by this little town?
What?
Over here? Did you go by
that
little town?
That way?
Yeah.
No. I went further north.
A little bit off center area, quite a bit actually. About it, it's not real far away. Do you know what channel PBS television stations are on now?
Channel ones.
They moved them off at 6.
I don't know.
Thank you. just shows up good, doesn't it?
I think I know some people that go to this church.
Yeah,
I think I do.
There's the old township or school. I'm not sure which. Township Hall. Imagine what it was like out here before they had any trees.
called?
Huge. Jeremy just dumped. Jeremy just dumped.
Yep. That's what I posted that it says. Garbage is out of the freedom site. Thanks to KC0SW and AB0KC. Instability forecast for tonight. That kind of looks kind of bad, doesn't it?
It's in Puerto Rico?
No, that's North Dakota there.
Oh, okay.
Instability forecast. I'm like, that looks a little high.